What is the function of blood? I am asking. For excretion. So the function of blood is to transport the substances within the body. Means in the body, so many substances they are needed for the survival. You can say the nutrient and the oxygen. So these they are just needed for their for the survival. Means the basic need of our body organisms life. They need some substances to survive. So the blood acts as a what you can say the agent of carrier, you can say it carries the different substances from within the body. So it transports the substances within the body, just like the nutrients and of course the waste products also. They carry the waste product and they help in excretion. So blood is very important, because it is a carrier of the different substances. Because the body needs oxygen or the nutrient, that all comes in the blood, and the blood carry to the different part of the body. Okay. Blood is made up of a straw colored fluid matrix called plasma. The fluid which is there in the blood, that is known as plasma, and which contain about 90% water. And if you just test the plasma, you will find that it's nothing, it's 90% water only, and it is the major component of blood. Blood also contains blood cells, dissolved salt and protein, and I told you that metabolic waste also, it also have, contains the hormones, means all the things are there in the blood cells, dissolved salts, nutrients, waste products. It's all there in the blood, and so the blood is having the two parts. One is the plasma, that is the liquid part, and another is the blood cells. Blood cells are of three types: white blood cells, red blood cells, and blood platelets. So the red blood cells are also known as erythrocytes, and white blood cells are known as leukocytes. And the blood platelets are known as thrombocytes. So erythrocytes, leukocytes and thrombocytes, three type of cells are there. So the blood is made up of liquid part, that is called plasma, and it's having the cells also. So three type of cells are there. They are erythrocytes, leukocytes and thrombocytes. Red blood cells are known as erythrocytes, white blood cells are known as leukocytes, and blood platelets are known as thrombocytes. So red blood cells are contain red pigment, that is called hemoglobin. Red blood cells or the erythrocytes contain hemoglobin, and hemoglobin is actually the carrier of oxygen and carbon dioxide. Means like we inhale the oxygen that comes in the lungs. So from lung, how it goes to the every cell of the body, because every cell of the body need oxygen, then only the body can survive. So how it goes to that every cell of the body, with the help of this hemoglobin that is there in the red blood cell. Hemoglobin having capability to attach with oxygen as well as from with carbon dioxide also. So the blood vessels which are present in the lungs, they are just what you can say, the oxygen enters in the blood vessels, and they just combine with the hemoglobin, you can say red blood cells, and these red blood cells carry the oxygen to the different part or all cells to the body, and there they just provide oxygen, and as a result of the metabolic activities, the carbon dioxide is released. So that carbon dioxide that is attached at the same time to the hemoglobin, and they carry the carbon dioxide, and then they leave it into the lungs. So the hemoglobin is the carrier of oxygen as well as carbon dioxide, because as in oxygen is very important to inhale, In the same way, the carbon dioxide is very important to exhale out. When the body exhale out the carbon dioxide, then only the body is capable to inhale the oxygen. So both the activities are very important, inhalation and exhalation. So for that, hemoglobin is very important. Hemoglobin combined with oxygen to provide the oxygen to the different part of the body, and from the different part of the body it carry the carbon dioxide again to the lungs so that carbon dioxide can be exhaled out. So the function of red blood cells is to carry carbon dioxide and oxygen. Then white blood cells they protect us from disease causing microorganisms. So they defend our body. They just act as the army of our body. They protect it from the all foreign bodies. They protect it from the the infection. Whatever the foreign bodies they see in the blood, they just engulf it, or they just, you can say, finish or kill it. So this white blood cell, they actually they form the defense system of our body. They're defending against the many infection or the foreign bodies. The third type is blood platelets. Blood platelets, they help in blood clotting. Means any time when we get hurt and the blood is started, the blood releasing from the body or from the wound, at that time what happen after some time, the blood loss is itself stop only. Means the black color clot is formed around the wound and the blood bleeding stops. So that blood clot, black color of clot, that is actually because of the blood clotting, and that blood clotting can be possible because of blood platelets. Blood platelets helpful in the blood clotting, and that's very important. If this blood clot will not form on the mouth of the wound, then the whole blood can be lost from the body and the person can die. So this blood platelets help in the blood clotting. Now Afan Rais, you tell me, what is blood and what is its composition? Afan Rais, Adnan Jamal, why no response is there from Afan Rais and Adnan Jamal? When I call your name, you should respond. At least you say Assalamu Alaikum, or at least you say I have not understood. But why you are not responding? Yasir Reza, you tell me the composition of the blood. Plasma. Plasma and okay, just tell me the two components. What are the major two components? Yes, what are the two major blood cell and plasma. When I ask you two components, you tell me plasma and the blood cells. Okay, and the blood, when I ask you how many types of blood cells are there, then you tell me three type of blood cells. They are erythrocytes, leukocytes and the thrombocytes. Yes. So basically blood is having two major components, that is plasma and the blood cells. Okay, so blood cells are of three types, remember: erythrocytes, leukocytes and thrombocytes. Erythrocyte, they basically the major function is to carry the oxygen and the carbon dioxide. And leukocyte, they form the defense system of our body. And blood platelets, they help in blood clotting. Okay. And the lifespan of the blood cell, red blood cells, that is 120 days. Okay. Now, lymph. Another fluid connective tissue is lymph. Two type of fluid connective tissues are there. Why fluid connective? Because their matrix is fluid. Because their matrix is liquid. So, one is the fluid connective tissue, that is blood. Another is the lymph. Lymphatic system is just a parallel circulatory system, you can say. Means like the circulatory system, we learn about that the major organ in the circulatory system are heart and the blood vessels. So, along with it, one more parallel circulatory system is there. That is lymphatic system. In this, the lymph and the lymph vessels are there. So, it's like the blood is running in the blood vessels. So, lymph is running that is in the lymph vessels. So, that also means the lymphatic system is the parallel circulatory system. The lymph is a straw colored watery fluid. From where it comes? It comes from the blood vessels only. When the blood flow in the blood vessels with the pressure, then some of the liquid that comes out from the blood vessels into the interstitial spaces. Interstitial spaces means like the space between the cells. Space between the cells is the interstitial space in which the blood that is running in the blood vessels, from that it seeps out from the blood vessels. Means this lymph comes out from the blood only. And the main thing is that, the lymph is not having red blood cells and it's having more number of the lymphocytes. So this lymph is nothing that is actually comes from the blood only, that seeps out from the blood vessels to give the nutrition to the interstitial spaces or the places where the blood vessels cannot reach properly. The function is to provide the nutrient to the places where the blood vessels cannot reach in a proper way. So this fluid comes out from the blood vessels, give the nutrient to the interstitial spaces or the areas where the blood vessels cannot reach in a proper way. And then the cells of that area, they utilize those nutrients, means oxygen and the nutrient. And then as a result of the metabolic activities, the waste come in the same fluid, that is the straw colored fluid, that is lymph. So that lymph is again absorbed by the special type of vessels or the different sets of vessels. They are known as lymph vessels. So lymph vessels, they absorb that liquid. The liquid which is actually seeps out from the blood vessels. Means this is the lymph which we are talking about. That seeps out, that comes from the blood vessels only in the spaces of the cells. And the cells are utilized the nutrient which is present in the lymph, and that utilized lymph means now you can say deoxygenated lymph, because the oxygen and the nutrient which is present in the lymph, that is utilized by the cells. And now this deoxygenated lymph, that is absorbed by the another set of vessels, that is lymph vessels. Then lymph vessels, they drain their liquid into the lymph node. The nodes are also present in the this lymphatic system, and these nodes drain their lymph into the veins. This lymph which is there in the lymph vessels, that drain into the lymph node, and from the lymph node into the veins. So veins are the part of the circulatory system. So the lymph which comes from the blood vessels only, that again comes into the blood vessels. Earlier they are seeps out from the arteries, and later they are drained into the veins. And the circulatory system we have studied in the sixth class. how the blood flows and how the heart pump the blood. So heart pump the blood, how the arteries are carrying blood to the different part of the body, and then the deoxygenated blood, the utilized blood, where the oxygen is not there, where the carbon dioxide more in amount, that blood is carried by another set of vessels, that is veins, and they just drain the blood into the heart again. So arteries carries the oxygenated blood from the heart, and the vein carries deoxygenated blood, and they drain into the heart, and then the heart they send to the lungs for the oxygenation, and then from the lungs again it comes into the heart, and then heart again pumped into the different body parts. So that is circulatory system. And from means like I'm telling you this all because you should not be confused with the lymph. What is this special type of thing? So lymph is also that comes from the blood vessels only, and that's the more or less the composition of the lymph is same. Only the main important thing is that red blood cells are not there in the lymph. Are you noting down these points or not? You should note down. And these lymph is rich in the lymphocytes. So this is all about lymph. And inshallah, in the next class we'll start muscular tissues. So whatever I taught you today, you just revise it. And inshallah, upload this recording. So if you have not made notes, to made no you start making notes also. And if then you will. Means when you will make the notes, you will know that what points you not understood. You can ask in the next class. I'll tell you, inshallah. So right now I'm just in my class. Assalamu alaikum. तुम कर लो अपनी एक दो क्लास, 9:30 पे क्लास शुरू हो रही होगी, जल्दी से एक दो क्लास ज्वाइन कर लो, लास्ट में मेरा
अब वही तो बात है, अब्बा घर पे मौजूद हैं, तुम क्लास नहीं कर सकते।